Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over problem number 3 on how to find the domain of rational functions algebraically. Okay, so the instructions for example 3 are for us to find the domain of the following rational function. So we're looking at f of x equals 5 times the quantity x minus 3 divided by 3x squared plus 14x minus 5. All right, so as we went over in problem 1 and 2, in order to find the domain of a function, we have to exclude any value that causes the function to have an undefined output from the domain. So what causes a function to have an undefined output? Any value that causes the denominator to attain a value of 0 results in a function having an undefined output. So that number should be excluded from the domain. All right? So to cut long story short, if you're asked to find the domain of a rational function that looks like this, a polynomial over a polynomial, you simply solve the equation where you set the denominator equal to 0 and exclude the solution of this equation from your domain, and that will be the domain of your rational function. All right? So in this problem, the denominator is where our focus is going to be. Our denominator is 3x squared plus 14x minus 5. So what do we do with our denominator? We set it equal to 0, as indicated here. This is a quadratic equation. Now, there are different ways we can solve a quadratic. The first method you always want to use is the factorization method. Let's hope that this expression is factorable, and then we can just simply find what the values to exclude from our domain are. All right? So I'm going to be using the X game or the AC method to factor this quadratic equation. AC goes on the top and B goes on the bottom, all right? In this problem, A is 3, B is 14, and C is negative 5, all right? So AC is 3 times negative 5, which is negative 15, and B is 14. The question now is, what two numbers multiply to give you negative 15 and add to give you 14? Now let's see. How about 15 and 1? Let's see, 15, and if we do 15 and 1, if we want the sum to be positive, that means the smaller one has to be negative. Okay, so let's try this. 15 times negative 1 yields negative 15. 15 minus 1 is 14. Excellent. Now, this quadratic has a value of a that's not 1, so we cannot take any shortcuts here. We actually have to factor this expression by grouping, okay? So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to have 3x squared. Now, these two terms that we got from our x game right here, we'll insert it in place of 14. Negative 15x minus x, actually positive 15x minus x, minus 5 equals 0. All right? These two numbers combine to give you positive 14. So we haven't changed the problem. We just changed the way it looks. Now we'll divide down the middle and now factor by grouping. All right? From the first two, I can extract 3x. That leaves me with x plus 5. And then from these two, I can extract negative 1. that leaves me with x plus 5 also equals 0. Now these two quantities in parentheses must be the same in order for our factorization to be correct, okay? So they are the same, so that's good. So we factor them into 1, x plus 5, and then if we factor out x plus 5, these two x plus 5s, we'll be left with 3x minus 1. And we'll group those two in their own parentheses, okay? 3x minus 1 equals 0. Okay, so now we have the factored form, x plus 5 times 3x minus 1 equals 0. We now have a situation that is similar to problem number 2. So how do we solve this? We're going to use the zero product property. All right, so to do that, we'll simply set both factors equal to 0. So we're going to do x plus 5 equals 0, and 3x minus 1 equals 0. All right? To solve the first equation, we'll subtract 5 from both sides. That gives us x equals negative 5. And then over here, this is a two-step algebraic equation. To solve it, we just take two steps, add 1 to both sides, and then divide by 3. Okay? So add 1. That gives us 3x equals 1. And then divide both sides by 3, okay? So if we divide both sides by 3, divide by 3, divide by 3, we have x equals 1/3. So what are these values? These are the values that causes our function to have an undefined output. So what do? These values must be excluded from the domain in order for all our output values to be defined, all right? So let's go ahead and write down our answer. What is the domain? The domain of the function is the set of all x's such that x is not equal to negative 5, and x is not equal to 1/3. Okay, so x cannot be any of these two values in order for our function to have a defined output. All right, so that is your final result. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. If you have any comments or questions, or you would like to request a video for us to make for you, feel free to include that in the comment section below this video. More clips can be found at mathgoserve.com. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.